Bushveld Minerals is a London-listed mineral development company with interest in tin and iron in the Bushveld complex in South Africa. Fortune Mojapelo is the chief executive, also talking today to the executive director, Anthony Viljoen. But Fortune, I want to start with you first of all and talk us through the project. And I guess the big question is, why the Bushveld?
Thanks, Jeremy, for having us. The Bushveld complex is it's a phenomenal mineralized body. It is host to 87% of the world's platinum resources. It is host to 74% of the world's chromium resources. Whatever it has in such huge abundance, and it is a structure that you cannot help but pay attention to. Our geologists have incredible amount of experience working on the Bushveld complex, understand it very well, and we believe that there are significant deposits still to be discovered on the Bushveld complex, and hence our focus on it.
You're within the company focused on iron, but you also have interest in tin, don't you?
We have iron ore and we have tin as our major projects which we're developing, in respect of both, we believe that the Bushveld complex presents a potential new province of mining for those commodities.
When looking down the list of what you've got, iron ore is a VTM deposit, I believe, is that right?
That's
explain
right.
What that is.
It's a vanadiferous titanomagnetite ore body, which means that it has three key elements: iron ore, it's a magnetite iron ore, it's got vanadium, it's also got titanium.
Are these extra elements economically viable? Are they economically extractable?
We believe they are, our studies hopefully will demonstrate that, but we also take comfort from the fact that there are several players in the world today who are processing exactly this type of ore bodies, and they are processing it and producing not only steel but also producing vanadium products and in some instances titanium marketable products, and they're doing it economically, so I believe we should be able to do this. The economics of this project, in our view, in terms of just the sheer scale of the ore body and its characteristics, lends itself, we would expect and hope, to economic extraction.
Anthony, let's bring in, talk about the other aspect of this project, the tin aspect. How important is this to Bushveld?
Look, in terms of what Fortune was describing with respect to the greater Bushveld, if you picture sort of a bowl structure as such, all the main elements of sort of form the rim of the bowl, but inside this is a younger sort of group of rocks which contain a number of very significant elements, one of which is tin. We've managed to consolidate a number of licenses around which at one stage was the second largest tin mining district in South Africa, and the mining ceased there when the tin price dropped down to $3,000 or even lower a ton. But what we've seen recently is tin has been one of the most significant performers on the London Metals Exchange, and we're reaching record prices of tin due to just a general lack of supply and a massive demand from the electronics industry. So what we're aiming to do is to go back and rework the old mining district, and why it's significant for Bushveld is that currently there's no exposure to tin on the London Stock Exchange despite the performance of the metal. So it gives investors exposure to a group of metals that.
Is it economically viable for any other price other than at these record highs?
Yes, it is, and also, but we've reached a new plateau in terms of the tin price. In our view, there's just not a lot of new deposits coming on stream, and the existing deposits have significant environmental liabilities, such as in Indonesia, for instance, So you know, this opens up a whole new way of looking at tin deposits.
Fortune, I want to return to you, talk about the development strategy, where you are and the funding behind you and so forth. What stage are you at the project?
So we've got, at this stage, we've got a resource which we have announced of 633 million ton resource.
The iron ore.
And that's on the iron ore. And that is on about 4.5 kilometer strike of what we consider potential 18 plus kilometer strike potential. Our objectives in terms of the development of the project going forward is to increase the resource, and this is to be achieved by further drilling along strike. And I need to emphasize that we're not adding the resource by going deeper, we're adding the resource by going along strike. We're looking at this as an open cast mining proposition, we believe we should be able to surpass a billion ton mark in the near future. When we came to the market, we talked about proving up more than a billion tons within 12 months.
Right.
We are on track with that objective, and believe we should be able to do that. Our recent drilling has added another 25% to the existing strike, the assays are at the labs, and we expect to get the results fairly soon. And we will, when we do get them, come out again with a resource upgrade. In exploration, you do have to be careful about, you know, throwing numbers. But it's an iron ore project, and we believe that for this type of project, scale is important, and we do need to demonstrate scale. And we believe that we've got what it takes to do that with this ore body. So that's one aspect. The other aspects of the deposit, as we mentioned, it's a VTM.
Sure.
We're running a metallurgical test work program, which is designed mainly to define things like the recoveries that we can expect, the sort of concentrate grades we can expect to see, as well as what sort of products would come out of this. You know, is it a concentrate product? Is it direct reduction pellet product, or is it pig iron? Or do you go even further than pig iron down to steel? All of these are components of a scoping study. And again, and to say, we say that we will be announcing a scoping study or presenting a scoping study report in the first quarter of 2013. We're fully funded through that, and we are working hard to do that within, of course, those timelines that we've spoken about. So, again, metallurgy, that's running. I do need to emphasize also that this type of ore body is an ore body that's, we're not looking for necessarily at new technologies in order to process it. It's been done.
Sure.
There are precedents for processing this type of ore body. The labs we're talking to who are working on this processing for us, have a sufficient familiarity and experience working with these types of ore bodies, so that gives us some degree of confidence of what we can expect to see coming out of that. And then the third angle, which I need to talk to about our program, is the infrastructure. Obviously, it's a bulk
commodity. I was going to say this. You said at the top how big the Bushveld is in terms of mineral deposits. Clearly, there's going to be infrastructure there. Briefly, talk us through what you've got.
We are in a mining district. We are about 10 kilometers away from the world's largest open pit platinum mine owned by Anglo Plat. We are about 30 kilometers away from a rail line, which is an existing line. So we have some infrastructure to start with, which we can access today to take product to port. I must state that the South African government announced a massive infrastructure capital investment program over the next 7 years with 300 billion rand, the bulk of which is going to rail and port infrastructure. That's obviously going to help projects such as ours. The company that is doing our infrastructure scoping study, Mott MacDonald, which is a British firm that many people would be aware of.
Yeah.
He's been doing a lot of extensive work in South Africa with the likes of Transnet around the infrastructure capital investment program.
Mm.
So we're working to make sure that this project is well aligned with this broader infrastructure development in South Africa.
Okay, all right, we must leave it there, but thanks for joining us, Fortune Mojapelo and Anthony Viljoen from Bushveld Minerals, one of the companies operating in the Bushveld in South Africa.
This film is for educational and leisure purposes only. Proactive Investors does not provide investment advice. The company is a publisher and is not registered with or authorized by the Financial Services Authority. Please refer to the full terms and conditions on the Proactive Investors website.